Hi everyone, it's good to see you all today. So my name is Shivam Mishra. I am one of the engineers at Frappe. I'm a developer, designer, I'm also the guy who knows how the office printer works. So yeah, that's one joke. So I no more jokes for the day. So yeah, I've been working with Frappe for more than a year now, and this is the Frappe team. So we are an open source product company based in Mumbai. So we are just a team of about 40 odd developers and consultants, and we try to bring great open source products to the world and make a small dent in the universe. We are a remote company. We have our few offices in Mumbai where most of the people work from, but there are a lot of people working from Pune, Bangalore, etc. So yeah, this is a photo from a recent cricket tournament, and the developer team was brutally beaten. Yeah. So yeah, so this is just a small screenshot from our website. These are all the projects we make, and I won't take much of the time on this slide. It's all on GitHub, and I'll just state a jump to our most amazing project. That's the Frappe Framework. So first of all, I would like to thank a huge round of applause to Rushab and Kailash for spoiling my talk. So let's talk about Frappe. Batteries included, metadata driven, full stack web framework, and that's a mouthful. So we'll take this all. Let's see if we can explain this in 10 slides. Spoiler alert, I'll fail. So tech stack, let's start with that. It's pretty standard for a Python-based web framework, and since it's full stack, so yeah, we have JavaScript. So it's written in Python, there's JavaScript. It works on top of MariaDB and PostgreSQL. Pretty standard. One of the most amazing things about Frappe is that it is a batteries included framework. Just like Python being a batteries included language, it extends that philosophy. And apart from the standard things that you would expect from a framework, let's say like Django, that's ORM, Migration Manager, REST endpoints, which still does not come out of the box in most of the frameworks. We have that, and there's more, like role permission manager, there is emails, real-time communication with Socket.io, job scheduler, we have payment gateways, we have native integration to AWS, Dropbox, Slack, and a lot more. And the next amazing thing about the framework is the magic ingredient. So this magic ingredient is central to how we manage complexity in the framework. And this is where the entire presentation gets a bit technical, but let's see if we can make it through. So this magic ingredient is called doctype. So just like in Django, you have views, or doctype describes the modules and the views of a data. Model creation is very simple. Since we have a very rich admin UI, you just go in, fill the forms, you fill in the fields for that particular model or table, so to speak, in the database, and then you add all the various dependencies, validations, any references, whether this is read-only, et cetera, and the model is created for you. Even the migrations are handled out of the box. So you see a doctype essentially not only stores fields, but also how this doctype will behave in their system. And this behavior, so to speak, is controlled or managed by the metadata-driven framework that is Frappe. So that's a lot of information on this slide. You don't have to read it. It'll be in the YouTube presentation. But let's understand the metadata-driven framework approach. So this is an example metadata. You can just look past through it. So model definitions, they should reflect both on the server side, the client side, as well as all your APIs. Sure, you can use Flask and create a good web app, but you won't need an ORM, so let's throw in SQL Alchemy. But you need forms, so let's throw in WT forms. Okay, you need REST endpoints, let's write a small serializer. So what happens is, you write your model, you create your controllers, you write your validations, you write your endpoints, and you're done, fine. But let's say you want to make a field filterable. So what you do is, you modify the model, you modify your serializer, you modify your endpoints, you modify your controllers. And let's say some X field has to be made mandatory. And you go through this mess all over again. Now this is a lot of complexity. Now imagine doing that for 10 tables. No, actually take it to 100. Or maybe let's make it ERPNext. Let's take it to 800 tables. So you need to manage this complexity really well to make a really robust system. So how do we do that? When you look at the metadata, so metadata is the data about data, right? That, you know, is the field visible, is the field linked to something? So when you look at the metadata, you realize that you can create abstract patterns that can drastically reduce this complexity. And when this is implemented in code, you get something called as doctypes. And in Frappe, all of this get handled at a very lower level. So all you get exposed to is very abstracted ORM, very abstracted model creation process, and very abstracted REST endpoints. And sure, you know, you can create all the clever models you want in any programming language, but what you will eventually make, you know, end up making is doc types. So this brings me to an amazing inception, and this is called the doc type conjecture. Any sufficiently complicated metadata-based web framework contains an ad hoc informally specified bug-ridden slow implementation of half of doc types. It's mouthful. So it's inspired by Greenspun's 10th rule of programming. It's about Lisp. But yeah, you can look it up online later. Again, do you want me to read it? It's quite sassy. Never mind. So Frappe Framework, it's built for rapid app development. And we want to ship really fast. So if you want a team of 20 people building an application as complex as an ERP, you need a framework that helps you ship really fast. If you want a team of 30 hackers building the largest stockbroking company in India, hi Kailash, you need a framework that helps you, you know, ship faster. And this is what Frappe Framework is for. You're creating models, controllers, and everything. It's handled out of the box. PDF, email, SMS gateway, you know, you name it. If you want something in a framework, we probably have it. If you don't want it, we probably have it. If it's not there, we are probably building it. You can build powerful extensions on top of Frappe. There is this interesting concept of apps and the entire thing, how this is architectured. It's going to be a long presentation if I start explaining this, but yeah, you can build your own apps that can bring their own models and then modify the behaviors of existing models. So it's quite extensible, and it comes with a very rich admin UI, and we call it Desk. Desk is a single page application. It was built before SPAs were cool. No fancy JavaScript framework. It's built on pure jQuery, and we love that. And it bundles with Frappe, and it's really powerful. And the why I say really powerful is Desk comes with a list view, a form view, a report view, Kanban view, that we have calendars, we have dashboards, and much more. And it is production ready. So we have a command line utility called Bench, which manages both the development and production environments. And so far it has been working great for 800 plus deployments that we have as our customers, and over 10,000 deployments that we know as a community, and has been working great for great teams. And it's battle tested essentially. ERPNext is built on top of Frappe. Zerodha uses extensively. Reliance has been experimenting with ERPNext, by extension also Frappe. Elastic Run is an amazing team from Pune which extensively use both ERPNext and Frappe. So let's talk about ERPNext now. So it's a fully featured open source ERP, and there's not much to say about an ERP. To understand an ERP, just as think of it as an operating system for your business. And it's a highly form-driven CRUD application, and it has complex reporting needs. So, you know, Rushabh and the entire team, we set out to build this amazing product with one commitment, and that is it has to be 100% open source. So there is no fine print, no asterisks. Everything we built, it's built in public. So any feature that we built is immediately merged to the bleeding edge branch, and then after testing is merged to the stable branches, and everything happens on GitHub. Just go to github.com/frappe and you can find all of our projects there. And just to talk more about ERPNext, so it has every module you need. We even pitch it as an open source alternative to SAP. It has account all the basics you need, plus a lot of domains like manufacturing, distribution, healthcare, education. We have a great LMS and everything. So people love this, and it has been acclaimed by a lot of people. Gartner rates it as one of the front runners, and it is a huge accomplishment for a humble project like ours. And beyond this, what makes us proud is the entire community that we have built around it. So this is discuss.erpnext.com. We know for ourselves that there are more than 5,000 deployments of ERPNext, and I think the stats are pretty undershooting. And this is a forum where in a month, more than 12,000 users make 3,000 posts, 10,000 unique user visits, and 600,000 page visits. And you know, this is pretty much it. But there's more. We truly believe in the philosophy of open source and sharing, and it's backed by a few foundations, and one of it is like we like to hack things, and we like to think things from first principles. So yeah, we were looking for a charting library, so we built one. So this is called Frappe Chart. It has over 13,000 stars on GitHub. It was trending on Hacker News. A great library, people love it. We couldn't find a great data table, so we set out to build one. So this is an amazing data table library. All of those projects, these are actively maintained. Data table library is quite stale because it's good enough for everyone. It's working for us. It powers the report view in the framework. And did someone say they need Gantt? We make that one too. So yeah, that's a small gist of what all projects we do. And you can look it up all on frappe.io. And that's about it. Any questions? You can ask me about anything, the development process and everything. Hi. Frappe is the framework that powers ERPNext. ERPNext is an app, and Frappe is also the name of the company. We build this product called ERPNext. So it's just like, you know, you use Django to build something. We use Frappe to build this amazing app called ERPNext. If you want to know the stories of the names and everything, Rushabh has an interesting way of, you know, putting all of it. So, you know, don't catch me, catch that man. That's about it. Thank you very much. You've been a great audience.